COVID-19 can cause self-attacking antibodies even in milder asymptomatic cases. When the body is attacked by germs, the immune system unleashes antibodies to contain the situation. Although these proteins do the job well, some cases are known to end up with auto-antibodies. A recent study suggests that COVID-19 can trigger such antibodies even in those with mild or no symptoms at all. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. You probably heard the word antibody, especially now there's a pandemic. But what about autoantibody? The first one refers to a special protein produced by certain immune cells to fight infection. When antibodies attach to their targets, these targets are disabled and become vulnerable to immune cells. The other refers to something that targets a person's own proteins. Simply put, antibodies attack foreign matter while autoantibodies attack native matter in the body. The latter is one main reason for autoimmune diseases. Despite their connection to autoimmunity, autoimmune antibodies have some upsides like killing cancer cells and removing waste products. According to Medical Express, investigators at Cedars-Sinai Medical Center found that people with prior infection with SARS-CoV-2 have a variety of autoantibodies up to 6 months after they have fully recovered. Their study, published in the Journal of Translational Medicine, is the first to report the persistence of autoantibodies over time after full recovery from COVID-19. Previous research only identified the elevated levels of these proteins, particularly during severe symptoms. The team recruited 177 people confirmed with COVID-19. After collecting blood samples, they compared test results to the ones from healthy people. Samples from those who had COVID-19 demonstrated elevated autoantibody levels. Some of the autoantibodies were similar to those found in patients with autoimmune diseases. While the autoantibodies related to autoimmunity usually impact women, the ones found in the study were more common in men. The findings reveal many things experts haven't seen before. If the results are solid, we may have an explanation as to why some patients experience long COVID. Plus, autoantibodies due to COVID aren't limited to severe cases. They have been found in mild or asymptomatic cases as well. What do you think about their findings? Do you agree that autoantibodies can last longer after COVID-19? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.